Good morning. Today I would like to explain to you addition and subtraction of fractions. Children, it is very easy when we have two fractions like 2 by 3 plus 1 by 3. Here the denominators are same. Okay? The denominators are same. As such, it is called as a like fraction, and the answer is 3 by 3 or 1. This is a like fraction. Okay. The addition is very easy because the denominators are common and you add the numerators. Suppose there is another number 2 by 5 plus 1 by 5. So because the denominators are common, you get answer 3 by 5. So whenever we have a common denominator, the subtraction or the addition is very easy. But when the denominators are different. For example, 2 by 3 plus 1 by 6. So the denominators are different. When the denominators are different, this is called as unlike fractions. What is it called? Unlike fractions. So the moment you see the denominators are different, you have to circle the denominators. So let us circle the denominators first because they are different. Now, this is the first step. You find that the denominators are different. Now, let us go to the second step. The second step is write all the multiples of the denominator 3. They are 3, 3 twos are 6, 3 threes are 9, 3 fours are 12, 3 fives are 15. Let us write the multiples of 6. 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 18. Okay? Now, here we find that there are 6 and 6. This is a common multiple in both the denominators, in 3 and 6. Even 12 is also there. But we are going to take the lowest one. Lowest one, that is the small one. The small multiple, we are going to take the lowest common multiple. This lowest one will become the denominator. That will become the common denominator for both, because there are in both the tables, that is in 3 table and 6 table. So now the common multiple is 6. Now 2 by 3 is equal to 6. So 3 multiplied by 2, we got 6. Now, so the numerator also has to be multiplied. 2 twos are 4. So the first one is solved. 2 by 3 is equal to 3 twos are 6. 2 twos are 4. Now, next one. 1 by 6 is equal to 6. Already 6 is multiplied by 1 time. So multiply the numerator 1 time. 1 ones are 1. Now we got 4 by 6 and 1 by 6. Both denominators are same. So it is very easy. You just add the numerators. 5 by 6. The denominators are common, so we can add the numerators. So this is the easiest method to solve unlike fraction addition. So 2 by 3 and 1 by 6, they are different. Find the multiples or find the factors which are related to 3, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. All the multiples you have written, all the 6 multiples you have written, take the common multiple, becomes the common denominator, and then you can solve the sum. Okay? Okay. Now, I will give you one sum for subtraction. Is it easy? Okay. That is 9 by 10 minus 1 by 5. So the first step is just decorate your denominators. They are both different, 10 and 5. Okay. By circling them. So 10, all the factors or all the multiples of 10. There are 10 ones are 10, 10 twos are 20, 10 threes are 30, 10 fours are 40. All the multiples of 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10, 5 threes are 15. But in the 5 table, there is 5, 10 and 15. In the 10 table, there is 10, 20, 30 and 40. The common multiple is 10 in both the one. So this is called the common one is 10. This is called the common denominator. Okay, which is called as the common denominator. It's called as the common denominator. Now we found the common. The first one is to circle it. First step is to circle. The second step is to find the multiple or the factors. Is the multiple. Now, the third step is with the common denominator. So let us take the common denominator. 9 by 10 is equal to 10. We got the common denominator. This is the common denominator solving. This is the third step. Okay? Common denominator. So we got 10. How did we get 10? 10 times 1 is 10. So multiply the numerator also one time is equal to 9 by 10. This is solved. Okay. 1 by 5. Common denominator is 10. 5. 2s are 10. 2 times. Top multiply by 2. You will get 2. 5 into 2 is 10. 2 times 1 is 2. Now we have to do the subtraction. Here is the third and the last step. This is the fourth final step. This is the solving step. Final one. So 9 by 10, because they are common, we can easily subtract 2 by 10. That is equal to 7 by 10. Okay, children? Because the denominator is common, it is easy to subtract. So I hope you understood the addition and the subtraction. The first step is circle the denominators. Okay, the second step is find the multiples. You can keep on writing the multiples you want, but 4 will be enough. Then you circle the multiple. Then this is the third important step with the common denominator. Now you got the common denominator 10, put the common denominator. And just to check how many times you got the common denominator from the actual one. So it is one time. Then 5 twos are 10, 2 ones are 2. So 9 by 10 minus 2 by 10 equals to 7 by 10. This is called as the fraction method. Okay, or factorization method by which we find the factors or we find the multiples of the given denominators. All the denominators, we find the multiples. What are the multiples? It's the least common multiple method. Okay, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Least common multiple we find. The common multiple we find. Hope you have understood the way to add and subtract. Thank you, children. If you have not still understood, I will explain it in the class.